In this video, I want to show you the mechanism of the Adam toy calculator. I have already removed the three buttons by pulling them off the stems and separated this top case from its base. It's made of a sheet metal. This one is three parts welded together, and it's attached to the base through these tab and slot fasteners. And inside you have this simple but ingenious mechanism. The three digits are each powered by these buttons, but the carry mechanism, well, it's not really a proper carry mechanism. It doesn't cause one wheel to move by the movement of the other. Instead, when a carry needs to be performed, the buttons directly drive the wheels that need to turn. But first things first, each button, it moves a wheel through this straightforward latch mechanism. At the back is a leaf spring that ensures that the wheel cannot move backwards but only can move forwards. It uses this sawtoothed gear on the side, and on this end is a pull that pulls on a tooth when you push down the button. So in that way the wheel can just move around. But notice that if I turn this wheel all the way around by hand, no carry will be performed. And yet, when I push this button, the carry is performed. The other buttons also drive their respective wheels in the same way. The leftmost button, the hundreds button, uses the left side of this hundreds wheel, and similarly the tens button uses the tens, the left side of the tens number wheel. But let's have a look at the carry from the tens to the hundreds. The pull uses this gear on the left side of the tens wheel, but the notch between the notch next to the nine is slightly deeper, so that now the pull rests slightly deeper and it starts to engage the gear on this this number wheel. That gear has a slightly smaller diameter, so now that same pull pulls both wheels at the same time, and now it only pulls on the tooth of the tens wheel, because it now no longer reaches the middle, reaches down to the hundreds wheel, until it gets to this deeper notch when it pulls both. A similar thing is going on from the 1 to the 10. The units button, it has one pull that moves the units wheel itself, and another pull here to handle the carries. On the left of the units wheel is a smooth ring, but it has a gap when it reaches the 9, and that allows that pull to move a bit deeper and engage with the 10th wheel. So that's very similar to what we saw here, but this gear on the 10th wheel also has a deeper notch when it reaches 9, and when that happens the pull can reach deeper into that gap in the smooth ring on the units wheel and engage with a metal ring metal gear underneath. That gear is attached to the axle, and the axle has this hundreds wheel fixed onto it so that it can't rotate separately from the axle. So when this pulls both the parts here, both the gear on the tens wheel and the metal gear that connects to the hundreds wheel, that's when both carries happen automatically. So let me show that again. So when you reach this gap, the pull can reach down and move the metal wheel underneath. That's the mechanism of the Adam toy calculator. Thank you for watching.